Hey guys, we're back. Today we have some iPhone 16 Pro Max cases that we just got from Apple. Two silicone cases plus another one by Beats. I didn't know that they made cases. So let's get right into it. We also got the new MagSafe charger for the higher speeds. So we'll open it up, take a look at it. It's just not going to work until we have the iPhone 16 Pro Max in hand. So let's get started. We got that ultramarine, which I'm super excited about. I love this color on the regular 16s. If I was going to get one of those, that'd be the color that I go for. I also like the teal, but that is pretty sweet. Let's pop it on the iPhone 15 Pro Max and just kind of see the size difference of the phones. So yeah, already there's just some headroom down there. So it's definitely going to be a larger phone, not by much, but you see the color that pops through if you have the natural titanium. Obviously the black, the white, and the gold desert titanium are all going to look different. But, you know, just kind of a color comparison. Here we have that capture button where it's supposed to be some type of crystals, magic crystals in there that are going to let us still use that and swipe through it. So that's kind of nice. It's not just a cutout like all the third-party manufacturers that I've seen online so far. I really like that touch. I've always liked the silicone cases by Apple. And that's just another reason I think that I'd probably want to stick with it. So we've got the action buttons, volume up and down rocker, and the power button. So not too much to it. Got the USB-C cutout, but that is the ultramarine. So let's take this off. Put it to the side. Now, this is called the Sun Kiss. It's just a really bright yellow. And I've said it, if you guys have seen my iPad Pro videos, when it comes to the Apple first party cases, iPad Pros, they don't do anything fun like this. So they do it on the iPhone Pros, just never with the iPads. So it would be sweet if we got some cool colors like this for the iPads, but at least they give them to us for the iPhone Pros, so they're not just dull and boring like black and dark muted colors. So this one's fun again. We got the magic crystals on the side. That's going to help us out when we actually have the phone in hand. Same thing. So you see the color comparisons. I like both of these a lot. There's also like a hot pink. That could be pretty cool too if that's your jam. But these are the ones that stuck out to me the most, especially the blue. So let's get into the Beats case. No real branding on it that I can see so far, except for on the inside. But let's open it up. Not as easy as the iPhones. So right off the bat, this thing is actually, it's not really silicone at all. It's got a really shiny finish. And it's got that open model where we saw back on like the iPhone 11s and below, that same design where it has the open bottom. So let's get this in there. So you see the open bottom. It says Beats right there. And that is just about it. No other branding on it, but it does have the magic crystals. So we get that in hand, but this is honestly like it feels like a colored clear case. Or even worse, it's like a bar of soap. So it's hard to tell with the, you know, not the right phone in the case, but this thing is super slippery. does got the MagSafe on there. If this was like silicone but just had a Fat Beats logo on the back, it probably would be pretty sick. But they call this the Midnight Black. It honestly looks more like a gray, is what I'm picking up on here. So I don't know about this one. Let's take it off. You can see that obviously the Beats right there, but you have a Beats logo inside here. You got a nice felt backing. This thing comes in a few colors. There's like a tan, a turquoise, and a purple. None of them honestly look that great, but I did want to check it out just because I've never seen a Beats case before. It's cool that they got the magic crystals in there, but right off the bat, I'm just not really feeling this one. So let's put that off to the side. Let's open up this new MagSafe that they got me to pay for again. I have the old one here from 2020 with the iPhone 12s. This one again starts at $40. There's two options this time. So this is the 1 meter cable length. Oh, it's nice and braided now. So that's cool. That's a little bit different, which it should be. So here's the old one. This is also 1 meter. And then here is the new one, if we can get this out. Tear it open a bit, get rid of that. So the actual pucks themselves, obviously this is brand new. This is about 4 years old now almost. Still looks in pretty good shape. A little discoloring, but you see the braided cable versus the old school just rubber wiring. So I like this a lot. I honestly don't even use the MagSafe cables too much. I used to, but now that there's just so many accessories with MagSafe on them, you know, we got battery banks galore that turn into stands. I kind of just use these products more. I did have a stand, like a just a metal thing to slide this puck in and use it as a stand. And I just got rid of it. I'm kind of pissed because I probably would have used it again. So this can go up to 25 watts. The old MagSafe, how it's always been, is 15 watts. And you know, now that Qi 2 just came out, you know, this Qi 2 charger, they go up to 15 watts now. You know, Apple was working with the power consortium, wireless power consortium, to help out with Qi 2. And now they're like, all right, well, if everybody else has 15 watts, let's finally bump ours up. So what's going to happen with all these Qi 2 chargers? Now those are going to be the slower ones, and there's probably going to be a whole slew of made for MagSafe new chargers that charge up to 25 watts, and those are going to be back up to like $150, just like all the old ones were. So where we thought we turned that corner when we got the Qi 2, but now we're just right back into it. If you know, are the type of person that wants those fastest speeds possible. So here's that look again. We're waiting on the new AirPod Pros as well. We're going to be pre-ordering the iPhones on Friday. I'm just kind of torn. I don't know if I'm going to go with that desert titanium gold or just straight up black. I haven't had a black one in quite a while. Pause. But I don't know. The gold is just kind of on the fence for me. I know it's the new color, but I don't know. I'm kind of leaning towards black. Let me know what you guys think in the comments below. What's your favorite color case that you've seen so far? There's a ton of silicone cases out there. These are the nice, cool, bright colors, but there's the muted ones, there's black, there's green, there's everything. I wish they came out with like that teal like they had on the 16 model, but they didn't. So are you guys picking up a 16 Pro? If so, what color are you getting? Let me know in the comments below. And until the next one, it's Buck Life. Peace.